Hey, it's your bro. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, we're going to be discussing backgrounds in CSS. So let's get into it. So before we begin this video, if you want to follow along, just find a background image that you like and download it. And for now, put it in the same folder that contains your index.html file and your style sheet. So let's begin. Now we're going to be discussing how to add a background to your website. This can be a background color or an image. So to kick this off, let's create a simple H1 header. So H1, let's add some text, perhaps background demo, and then close this. Let's save, reload, and we just have some text. Now we're going to mostly be working on our style sheet. Now, if you want to target the background of your website, you can simply just target this body element. However, there's a better option than targeting the body, and that's actually targeting the HTML element, because that will pretty much cover everything. So you can see here that pretty much everything is within the HTML tags. So we're going to target this HTML tag for our style sheet. Now, if you want to change the background color, we've covered this already. You just type in background color, and this is a property, and we can set this to a color, like maybe green. Save, reload the page. Oh, there you go. That's it. Lesson over. Just kidding. And for colors, you can also use an RGB value, which is red, green, then blue. Just type in RGB, then a set of parentheses. And there's three values that you can place within the parentheses here. It's a number between 0 and 255. And depending on what value you place for each of these different positions, this will add varying amounts of red, green, and blue. So I'm just going to type in some random numbers. I have no idea what this color is, but we'll see what it is. So I just made up the numbers 100, 255, and 75. Let's save, reload the page. And that's like a bright green lime color, which is kind of interesting. Otherwise, you can use hexadecimal values. So you need a number symbol. Then you can type in a series of 6 digits. Like all zeros would be all black then, all Fs would be all white. And you can look online for some hexadecimal values if there's anything you like. Let's talk about gradients. A gradient is a gradual change from one color to another. That's the best way I can explain it. Let's say that on our website, we want the background color to start at one color, and then by the end of the document, it will become another color, and it's going to gradually change colors, kind of like a sunset. You know how there's varying colors? That's kind of what a gradient is. It's just a gradual change in colors. So this is what we can do to create a gradient effect. Type in background. We'll use the background property. Linear-gradient, then a set of parentheses. Let's start with two different colors. We want a gradual shift from one color to another for our background. Let's say we want maybe gray, and we want this to transition to black. And you can use either RGB values or hexadecimal values here. I'm just going with the words gray and black just because it's simple for this video. So let's save, reload. All right, so we're starting to get somewhere. So what's going on here is that our background gradient is only extending as far down as we have substance on our website, basically. Since we only have an H1 header tag, the gradient is only going down so far. If I were to add, let's say, a paragraph to this, so if you're using Sublime Text, you can just type in lorem and hit tab and save this. Well, the gradient now extends for as much as we have text or other items on our website, and then it will repeat itself every so often. But if you want your gradient to extend to the entire window size, these are the steps to do that. So the first thing that we're going to do is that we're going to prevent our web browser from repeating this gradient every so often, depending on how much text you have or other items on your website. So background-repeat, then we'll set this to no repeat. So this doesn't repeat anymore, but we have all of this blank white space underneath all of the items on our website. So there's a few other steps. We're going to set the background-position, and we will center this. This isn't really going to be noticeable quite yet, but when we include background images, it's going to be more noticeable. So no apparent changes yet. We will set the background-size to cover. Again, no noticeable changes. And lastly, we're going to set the background dash attachment to fixed. And what this does is that this determines if the background will scroll with the rest of the page or if it's fixed in place. So when you combine all of these together, all these properties, what you get is that the gradient or your background image will extend to the full length of your browser window. And if you were to resize this window, it's actually going to expand naturally. So that's what a lot of people tend to want. They want their background image or color to extend to the full length of the browser window. Now, if you would like to set an image as your background, these are the steps. So for now, I'm going to comment out everything that we did here, and we'll just use this as a reference and we'll start fresh. So the first thing that we're going to do is that we're going to include a background image. So background-image, colon, URL, a set of parentheses. Now, there's two things we can type in here, either the file name, if it's within the same folder. For this example, for me, I put this in the same folder, but in just a moment, I'll show you where you can locate a image that's in a different location or a different folder. So type in the name of the image here. So I picked a file that was named space underscore small dot png. Let's save this, reload the page. All right, here's my background, but I'm going to change the font color because I can no longer read it, and I'm just going to set that to white. So one thing you might see is that with images for a web page, all the images might be in a separate folder. So we'll need to add the file path for where we can locate our background images. So let's create a new folder. So new folder, and I will call this images, and we're going to take our background. In my case, I have two here because I'm going to show you another example, and we'll place it within a folder called images. So now if we were to reload this page, we can no longer locate this file. So we'll actually have to add that folder here. So we're going to type images or whatever else you named your folder, then forward slash, then the name of the file. So if we were to reload this, we can now see our background. But for this example, I'm just going to put everything back within the same folder as it was originally. So let's expand this window. All right, so what's going on here is that this portion right here is the background image, but it seems like it's repeating itself to fill in the entire width and height of your web browser too. So what I would like to do is that I want to take this background image and have it extend to the full size of my browser window. So it's going to be the same steps as before then, the same that we did with the linear gradient. The first thing that we're going to type is background-repeat. So I'm going to just place that here. Let's save, reload the page. So this is the original image that we have for our background, and it's not repeating anymore, but we still want this to take up the entire size of our browser window. So the next thing we're going to do is set the background position to center. All right. So now this image is in the middle of our web page. We want this background size to be set to cover. So now this background image covers the full width of the web browser. However, we still have this white space underneath it. And then lastly, we're going to set the background attachment to fixed. And this determines if the background will scroll with the rest of the page or if it's fixed in place. So when you combine all of these properties together, what you end up with is a background image that takes up the entire size of your browser window, which again is what people tend to want instead of just their background image only taking up like a certain portion of this window. And with this background image, the more you zoom in or the larger the window size, the image itself will begin to lose some quality. So you're better with using high resolution pictures. But for this example, I had a small version of the background image I wanted to use. I'm going to switch this to a better, larger resolution picture that I had. And the file that I had was space underscore big. So now the resolution of the picture is slightly better. But you also have to be concerned with how large the image is that you want to use for a background, because that might increase the load time for somebody viewing your page then. So that's something to keep in mind. but higher resolution pictures tend to be better if you're using it as a background image. So that's the basics of adding a background color, gradient, or image to your web page as a whole. Now you can also add a background to specific HTML elements. Let's say that we want to change the background of our H1 header tag, which we have at the top. So we'll add that to our style sheet, H1, set of curly brackets. Let's add a linear gradient for the background. So we'll type in background linear gradient parentheses, and then we can type in the colors we want within the parentheses. Now you can have more than two. Before we just had gray and black, we can add more colors. Let's say we want like a sunrise or a sunset effect. We can type in red, then orange, and then yellow. So let's see what this looks like. That's pretty sweet. But why stop there though? We can make this a whole rainbow if we really wanted to. So let's add a few other colors, maybe green, blue, indigo, and violet. Sweet. That's a pretty cool looking rainbow. It kind of reminds me of that meme. I think it was called Nyan Cat. Yeah, this is it. This is what this reminds me of. Assuming most people wouldn't want a rainbow background, but for this tutorial series, I'm going to include this because, well, it's my tutorial series and I can do what I want. So now how about we change the background color of this paragraph that we have? So let's go back to our HTML file and I need to surround our paragraph with a set of p tags, and I'm assuming you probably do as well. So make sure you include those. We're going to list the p element as our target, and let's change the background. Perhaps we'll use another linear gradient because there's a few other tricks that we can do too. Perhaps we will use the boring gray and black that we had previously. So our gradient only targets this specific paragraph. Another trick with linear gradients is that you can have the colors flow in a different direction. By default, it starts at the top and the color eventually transitions to its second color when it reaches the bottom. So you can actually change that direction. Like we can have gray start on the left and when it reaches the right, it'll become our second color. So within the parentheses, we're going to type to right, comma, and now our first color is on the left, and it eventually transitions to our second color on the right. Otherwise, there's two top, so it's kind of like these positions are reversed, and two left. So use whatever you want for your website. I kind of like two right, honestly. That's pretty sweet. Here's one thing to consider. What if you had a bunch of different paragraphs? This is what this might end up looking like. So I'm just going to take our current paragraph and just paste this maybe an additional three times so we have four paragraphs. So each of these paragraphs has their own what looks like an individual box. So if you don't want these basically blank empty spaces between each of these paragraphs, what we can do is actually put all these paragraphs within its own container using a div tag. So before the first paragraph, we're going to begin a new div tag. And we'll give this a unique ID, such as my text. Name this whatever you want, really. And then outside of the last paragraph, we're going to close this div tag. And within our style sheet, we can target everything within this specific div tag. So if you're targeting something with a unique ID, you need to put the number sign and the name of the div tag, or whatever the name of the ID was, and I already forgot what it was. My text, okay, so we're just going to type that here. So my text, set of curly brackets, and I'm going to take our linear gradient that we had for our paragraphs, and I am going to place it within my text now. And we'll reload the page. Now we got rid of those empty spaces before and after each paragraph, and it's all one uniform background, basically. One pretty unique feature about this is that if you have a scroll bar, you'll notice that as we move up and down on our webpage, you'll notice that the actual background image is staying in place and all of our text is moving as if it was on some sort of track or rollers maybe. It's kind of like there's two layers. There's a background image and then there's all of our text that's moving. So that's kind of cool to see. So that's the basics of backgrounds in CSS. If you would like a copy of the markup that we worked on today, I'll post this in the comments down below and pin it to the top. But yeah, that's how you add a background in CSS. Hey you, if you enjoyed this lesson, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.